Do I need to take supplements of omega-3? This is a common question that I usually get from my patients with chronic pain. Actually, many of them already come to me taking fish oil supplements because they heard it was good for their joint pain, arthritis, fibromyalgia, etc. Do they really need to take fish oil supplements that contain omega-3? I will answer this and other questions in the video today. So, let's talk about omega-3 supplements today. Our body does not produce our own omega-3 fatty acids. That's why they're called essential fatty acids. We only obtain them from diet. When we say omega-3, we are talking about a type of fat that is found in cold water fatty fish like salmon, mackerel, tuna, herring, and sardines. There are smaller quantities of omega-3 in seafood like shrimps, oysters, and lobsters. The main type of omega-3 fatty acids that our body needs are EPA and DHA. You don't need to know how to pronounce these complicated names. These two types of omega-3 are what is found in fish and seafood. An adult only needs 2 portions of this fish per week to get a good supply of EPA and DHA. For people who don't like fish or are vegan, there are plant-based oils that contain omega-3, a different kind of omega-3 called ALA. The plants that contain ALA are flaxseed, chia seed, soybean, canola oil, walnuts, and dark green vegetables like kale and broccoli. ALA has to be converted to EPA and DHA in our body, but only 5 to 15% is transformed into a usable form. So this means that the person has to eat a lot of ALA to have enough EPA and DHA. There are also fortified foods with DHA and other omega-3s like eggs, yogurt, milk, and soy beverages. So read the labels. Now, why are omega-3 fatty acids important? Omega-3 and omega-6 are polyunsaturated fatty acids, or PUFAs. Omega-6 fatty acids are also essential fatty acids. We need to ingest them. They are important for our immune system and blood clotting. There are 4 types of omega-6: linoleic acid, LA, arachidonic acid, ARA, gamma-linoleic, GLA, and conjugated linoleic acid, or CLA. Omega-6 are found in meat, poultry, fish, eggs, soybeans, corn, sunflower oils, nuts, and seeds. Omega-3 is anti-inflammatory, and omega-6 is pro-inflammatory. Well, we do need to have some inflammation in our body, otherwise we cannot fight virus, bacteria, fungus infections, or kill cancer cells that develop and grow in our body every day. So we need some inflammation. However, when we have an imbalance in our diet, or we eat more pro-inflammatory than anti-inflammatory fatty acids, there is a tendency to maintain an inflammation in the body that is not healthy. And if you don't have enough omega-3s to counterbalance the omega-6, then you will always be in this chronic state of inflammation. In North America, people eat much more omega-6 in our diet than omega-3. The proportion of omega-6 to omega-3 in North America is 25-1. Why is that? Well, the shelf life of omega-3 is very small. Food rich in omega-6, they last weeks or months. They're more stable. So next time you go grocery shopping, look for the amount of omega-6 contained in processed food that you buy. In people with inflammatory diseases like rheumatoid arthritis, the goal is 1:1. In healthy adults without chronic inflammation, a good goal is 4:1. Remember, the goal is not to eliminate omega-6 from our diet. We need them too. The goal should be a better amount of omega-3 to maintain a healthy balance. For people with chronic pain, here are some benefits of a rich omega-3 diet. It reduces the need to use non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs or NSAIDs like ibuprofen or naproxen. There is less post-operatory pain levels. It improves symptoms in painful diabetic neuropathy. It reduces the use of antidepressants. It decreases tolerance to morphine. There are less symptoms in people with rheumatoid arthritis. Less menstrual cramps, especially when taken with vitamin E. Better function in people with knee osteoarthritis. And it improves symptoms of inflammatory bowel diseases. That's why it's important to watch what we eat and make conscious decisions about choosing a more balanced anti-inflammatory diet. Well, this type of inflammation that I'm talking about is not visible. It is not like the swelling and pain that you feel when you have an inflamed tooth. We're talking about micro-inflammation in the blood vessels. There are other health problems too related to deficiency of omega-3 fatty acids. It can lead to high blood pressure, heart attack, and stroke. And there is some suggestion that it's also implicated in dementia, depression, and macular degeneration. But these studies in these areas are still inconclusive. I usually don't recommend supplements. I prefer that patients obtain the nutrients they need from a balanced diet. However, if you choose to take fish oil supplements, take at least 1,000 milligrams a day. For pain management, choose supplements with a 1.5:1 proportion of EPA and DHA, so more EPA than DHA. To avoid fish burps, which is fish taste in the mouth after ingesting the fish oil tablets, you may freeze the tablets and ingest them before bedtime. Be careful. Too much fish oil can lead to increased risk of bleeding, and they also may interfere with warfarin, a common medication used to prevent blood clots. If you have another supplement that you'd like me to review in a video, just write down your suggestions in the comment box below. I already have other videos about vitamin D, magnesium, and glucosamine with chondroitin. Please don't forget that this video is only for educational purposes. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is an emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. If you like this video, give a thumbs up here, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. You can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Goodbye!